Hello all, welcome to my channel Crystallized Science. So I am here with a new video of class 10. The topic is electricity. So let's start with basic. In this video we'll study about flow of charges in conductor. We'll study about charge, that is electric charge. We'll study about electric current. So let's start. As you all know that conductor conducts current, right? And that current belongs because there is a charge which is acting on a conductor. So what is charge? The quantity which is responsible for conduction of electric current is known as charge. जो electric current को represent करता है उसे ही हम charge बोलते हैं. Okay. So what is the unit of electric charge? It is coulomb, as it was invented by a great physicist, that is coulomb. Now what does this diagram signify? In our textbook there are two types of current given, that is conventional current and electron current. In conventional current, the direction of current is from higher potential to lower potential, while in electron current, as the name suggests, the current will exist from negative terminal to positive terminal. But in each and every numericals in our textbook and each and every electric circuit, we will consider charge as a conventional current, that is it will flow from positive to negative direction. But how does this charge flows, or what are the forces which act on a charge due to which an electric current flows in a circuit? Let's see. So here, as you can see, that this positive terminal will repel proton. Due to this repulsive force, this proton will reach to the opposite end, and in opposite end there will be an attractive force which will attract proton to its terminal, that is negative terminal. So in this way a proton travels its journey, and in this way our conventional charge flows from positive terminal to negative terminal, and in this way electric current is conducted in the circuit. Okay, so let's see now what is charge. Charge can be of two types. It can be proton or it can be an electron. Charge which flows in a circuit, or the circuit which conducts proton, such circuit conducts which current? That is conventional current. Or a circuit which conducts electron, that conducts which current? That is electron current. Now what is proton, or what is the charge over a proton? So the proton is nothing but 1.6 into 10 raised to 19 coulomb. This value is derived by coulomb. Now here positive charge will be existing, as proton has plus charge, and in electron there will be negative charge, so minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, now coming back to electric current. What is electric current? Electric current is nothing but number of charges flowing in a conductor per unit time, is known as electric current I, right? And what is the formula? I is equal to Q by T. Q is charge, T is your time. What is its unit? Its unit is ampere, or its another unit is coulomb per second. So we can say that there are two units of electric current, that is ampere or coulomb per second. And what is the definition which is most probably asked in each and every paper? That is, what is electric current? So number of charges flowing in a conductor per unit time is known as electric current I. And as you all know, charge consists of two types. It consists two types. Which are they? They are proton and electron. And each and every charge has its own value. Proton is plus 1.6 into 10 raised to 19 coulomb, and electron is minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Okay, thank you. So we have seen about charge, we have seen about current. Now which element constitute an electric circuit? Which element constitute an electric circuit? So there are many elements which constitute an electric circuit, or we can make circuit schematic due to it, right? So let's see. So first element, that is cell. Cell consists of two terminals, that is positive and negative. When series of cell combines with each other, then it makes a battery. You can see over here there are two cells which make a battery. In order to connect each and every component in a circuit, we need a wire, and it is a joint wire, or it can be a separate wire. There is an ammeter which is used to measure current. There is a voltmeter to measure potential difference. Potential difference is only responsible for generation of current, right? So it is a difference which is essential in a circuit for a charge or current to flow from one end to another end. That is known as potential difference V. G, as you can see over here, it is nothing but a galvanometer. Resistor R. Now this resistor R is nothing but a quantity which is used to limit electric current. It limits electric current. Okay. Now rheostat. Rheostat or variable resistor. This we use generally in our home as a regulator. We generally vary our speed with the help of rheostat or variable resistor you may be using in day-to-day life. So this is nothing but rheostat. And also galvanometer is used as a tester to detect whether there is a current presence or not in an electric board, right? So this is generally used by electrician, and the name is which is used generally is tester. So here two unit is defined in a textbook of ampere, that is 1 microampere is 10 raised to minus 6 ampere and 1 milliampere equal to 10 raised to minus 3 ampere, right? So it is generally used to interconvert the current. So if I am writing 1000 microampere, then if you calculate, it will be nothing but it will be equal to 1 milliampere, okay? And what will be 1 milliampere? It is nothing but 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So this is used generally to interconvert the unit of current. Now let's see, if a question is asked that define SI unit of electric current I, then what will be the answer? The answer is 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb per second. This is actually the formula. What will be the definition? If 1 coulomb charge flows in a circuit in 1 second, then I can say that in a circuit 1 ampere current is flowing. If 1 coulomb charge flows through a circuit in 1 second, then 1 ampere current flows through a conductor or a circuit. So this is nothing but the definition of SI unit of current I. So in this way, you can find the different values of current by using interconversion values. You can draw a schematic of a circuit by using such circuit elements as we have seen: cell, battery, wire, ammeter, voltmeter, galvanometer, resistor, rheostat. Each and every element has its own significance, right? So we will also see about quantization of charge. What is quantization of charge? We will see that. Okay, so what is quantization of charge? The number of protons or electrons flowing through a circuit is called quantization of charge. It is represented by symbol Q. And what will be the formula? Q is equal to N into E and N into P. P stands for proton, E stands for electron. Here N is nothing but number of charge. So in your textbook, the numericals based on numerical is given based on quantization of charge. So as we all know, formula of quantization of charge is Q is equal to N into E. So in text, first question of electricity chapter, quantization of charge numerical is given that if charge is given in a circuit as 2 coulomb, you have to find number of electrons in it. So what is value of electron? Minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. What is formula? Q is equal to N into E. So will be N will be equal to Q divided by E. Q is nothing but 2 divided by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Let us remove the point. Power will change to positive as it will go to numerator. 20 divided by 16, answer will be 1.25 into 10 raised to plus 19. Now note that there is no unit I have written over here, as the unit of charge and electron is same. Both has same unit, that is coulomb. It will be cancelled out, so there will be no unit, right? So in this way you can solve the quantization of charge numerical. Now let us see the numerical based on current as well as charge. As you all know, the current formula is Q into T. And what is charge formula? Q is equal to N into E. So if the question is given that if the charge flowing through circuit is 2 coulomb and time given is 2 seconds, then if you want to find what is electric current, then what will be the formula? I is equal to Q divided by T. And the answer will be 2 coulomb divided by 2 second, 2 will cancel out, answer will be 1 ampere. Okay, so it's too easy, right? But if In the question, it is given that time is given as 1 second, number of electron in a circuit is 2, right? And you have to find electric current. Then if this is second type of sum that can be asked in an exam, if the time and number of electron is given, right, then how will you solve this to find electric current I? So let's see, formula of I is Q divided by T. Also we know that Q is nothing but N into E. So Q is equal to N into E. So 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 divided by time is given as 1 second. So what will be the answer? Answer will be 3.2 into 10 raised to minus 19 ampere current will be flowing through the circuit if the time is 1 second. Okay, so in this way, these two type of numerical are given in your textbook. One, if the charge and time is mentioned, then you have to use I is equal to Q by T. And another, if you are given the question that if number of electrons are given and time is given, then the formula is I is equal to NE upon T. You have to remember both of this formula and you can solve this numerical easily. Okay, thank you for watching this video.